It's an honor to share with you some idea and experience that we made at the Swiss Parliament. And as you maybe know, I like to speak about information systems development for Parliament. So I ask myself every day if I'm more a researcher or an IT specialist. I think after years, I'm both, and that is the thing that is very interesting. And I think the excellence around that idea of development of information system for a parliament can be a new role or a very important role for researcher within a parliament. I'd like to make a short presentation in three parts. The first part is speaking about the information systems of the Swiss Federal Assembly. Then speaking about what we did the last years in terms of development of that systems, our new roles as researchers within the parliament and as researchers. And then I will try to conclude with some point. The first thing, which is very interesting, at the Swiss Federal Assembly, we had two ways of development of that information systems. We had the first purpose or the first way to develop them, which was a very administrative way in order to support a parliamentary process. And we had, on another side, the researcher or librarian who had developed their own systems without having a lot of interconnection between the systems. And I think it's a normal way, and in most of the organization, we had that common model of development for the information systems. What we can see is that we were not, as researcher, part of the development of this supporting information systems. So we had to build during the years, the last 20 years, lots of very complicated interfaces in order to bring the information to our need or, as researcher. And we were not the first priority, and we had to develop, like a special, a small solution in order to do our jobs. And what we can see, we have on that way the administrative information system of the parliament that works great. They are interconnected. And we have a lot of other systems to do our job as researcher. And we have to work with, hundreds of systems, hundreds of platforms, of different platforms in order to find our information. And it was the same problem for the parliamentary. So they have to deal with lots of systems. And they often use Google because they think it's more efficient and they find everything. So that's the first conclusion we made. And we said, well, we have maybe a role as researcher or librarian in the development of information system for parliamentary and for the entire parliament. We have something to say because we have an overview of all the process in the parliament. We have an overview of all the politics about the society because we have to answer lots of questions. And maybe with that experience, we could influence in a good way the development of future information systems, especially for the parliamentary. It's a huge challenge, and we decided at the Swiss Parliament to start in that way. We began with a big project. It was an internal project. We call that, in IT words, it's a project around business intelligence. So the idea is to take every database of the parliament, main databases, and to merge them in order to work with the information from many different aspects. So it's not the purpose to build one system for one task in the parliament, for example, the vote in a chamber, or the systems that manage all the bills, or a system that is taking all the words that are said in one chamber or in commissions. We decided to merge all that systems in order to get more information, to be more precise about the parliamentary works. And it was a huge challenge. We had to go back to study and to learn IT issues. We had to understand how IT people work. And it was great. It was very interesting. And what we said, what we saw is that at the end, we had for the first time a big new information system that was had and made by the Library of Parliament, which was totally new. And the experience was great for IT people and for researcher. And we have now the possibility with that system to better the quality of the data produced within the parliament, and we have the possibility to ask the system lots of very precise facts about how the parliament is working, for example. And the need for that system is very, it is growing. We have lots of parliamentarians that discover that we had so a system and have lots of questions, and we try to answer by using that system. So that was the first part, really, building up a new system within the parliament. And then we decided that, and we saw that the problem was for the parliamentarian to make their job very easily without using Google, for example. I'm saying that it's not against Google, but it's the way lots of people are working today. And the idea was to centralize every important data for the parliamentary work within one platform. That was the idea. So we decided to start a second project, which was much more larger. We called it Soprano, because it was, the top of everything. And we decided that in that project, we had to monitor the political issues. That was the idea of that project. So we had to merge every parliamentary database or data or information that was very useful for the parliamentary work, and we had to merge other very important sources that comes and that makes 90 or 95% of a parliamentary works when it comes to start new ID or to begin to work on a new bill. And that sources are very, they are known because we're working with that sources as researcher. So we have the old production of the administration or the government. We have what the courts produced. We have the media, the press, the online press. We have the lobbyists. We have the regional administration. So lots of data. They are very well known. But you have to go on, each systems in order to find what you like to find. And we started to build and to construct that systems. We made two prototypes. They was very interesting what we could do with that. And we are now in development for that big system. We had the opportunity to speak with some parliamentarians that are very interested in IT matter, and they were very interested. They all said we were waiting for SOA system for a long time, and they'd like to help by doing that systems. That system is very interesting because it concerns not only the researcher within the parliament, it concerns every people or colleagues that are dealing with the in the parliamentary processes. It could be legislative or control or budget question. So every people are interesting in helping by doing that systems. So it was a way to come back in the center of the parliamentary services and to be at the very beginning of a new system and to bring in that system our knowledge, which is huge, and because we have that overview of every issues. We have lots of colleagues in the parliament that have just an overview of their field and they develop something for them without thinking on the others that are doing the same thing and developing something other too. So it was the first time that we merged every interest in one reflection. And it works great. I'm not going to demonstrate that system today because it's in development, but maybe in the few years, in the next few years, it could be very interesting to have a look of that systems. As a conclusion, we have that issue of post-factual politics, and post-factual politics without digital or globalization of information systems is not possible. So if we're not supposed to be good in post-through or post-factual politics, we can be very good in information systems. It's maybe 50% of the issues. And I think we can have a very, very great role, new roles, and building up new information system for parliamentarian. I can say that the technology is there. It's not something very new. So if you give the IT people the right specification, you can get the right systems. You don't have to invent something very new. The technology is there. We saw that by doing our prototypes, our two prototypes. We have 100% of the business know-how that is available. It's in our head. And lots of people in the parliamentary services work there for a long time. So they know everything about everything. So it's not a problem to give the right specification. and then we have to find resources in order to develop these information systems. We all know that when we are doing research, we have no time to do other jobs. It could be development of information system or other things. So we have to find a way to have time in order to do that. For example, we merged the library and the research services in order to get new resources to do that. I'm speaking about the Swiss case. In Switzerland, it worked. And we have the final thing is to be very quick in the answer, and is to see how we can bring a big added value in the information that we share, that we give the parliamentarian. I think that's the key point. And when we take time in order to develop that systems, lots of think or information can be given very proactively. So you increase the way that information can be done automatically, so you can concentrate yourself in much more bigger issues that take times, that take special know-how, and that need researcher. So that's the Swiss experience I wanted to share with you. As said, it's a more technical way to, more technical approach, but we're convinced in Switzerland that we have a good role to play in that issue of development of information system. Thank you very much.